Hi everyone, welcome back to the Phoebe Way. Hope you're all doing well. Today's video is a collaboration with Patricia from the channel Life Seasoned. And guys, go ahead and check out her channel. She documents her life in Germany as well.
Hi everybody and welcome back to Life Seasoned. I'm so happy to be back again here. So I'm in Niedersachsen in a place called the Winter Wonderland. If you look around, like, you see a lot of wonders pertaining to winter. We have a lot of snow, like, for the past days, and it's pretty been amazing. Okay, so I'm doing a collab with Phoebe, the Phoebe Way, and we're going to talk about legal issues a little bit that has to do with Zambia, Germany, and a little bit concerning Ghana, because Phoebe is from Ghana, and she'll talk more about Germany and Ghana. I know a little bit about Germany, but she's been here longer. I'm Zambian, so let's get right into the video.
In today's video, we are going to highlight the differences between the legal systems of Germany and Zambia / Ghana. We are going to concentrate on certain topics, mainly married, getting divorced, and buying property, buying estate here in Germany, and the differences in the Zambia system. I'll use this opportunity to wish you a prosperous new year. Hope 2021 gives you everything that your heart desires. And yes, I'm happy to be with you today. So let's get right into the video. We prepared some questions. We're going to go ahead and answer these questions and also keep it short and not too much into detail. So if you want any more advice, see a lawyer, see a family lawyer, see a notary and ask your questions, okay? This is just the surface for you to have a basic understanding of what's going on.
So Phoebe asked me, or we ask ourselves, what types of marriage exist in Zambia? Yeah, in Zambia, two forms of marriage, and that's like tradition and the statutory one. The tradition one is the one you get married at home or just family, friends. You don't go to the state or to court or anybody anywhere. Yeah, and the statutory one definitely has to come from the statute, because that one is in the constitution of Zambia and it's more supreme, it's more higher than the traditional marriage. Yeah, for both marriages, you get a marriage certificate. You can go to the local court for the customary marriage, which is a traditional marriage. It's also recognized by the state or the law of Zambia. And for the statutory one, you go to the high court or other entities like agencies, like the council, high courts that give this kind of marriage certificate.
What type of marriages exist in Germany? There used to be the registered partnership, but obviously it is not marriage and it's also not in existence anymore. It was introduced as, at that time, same-sex marriages were not legal or were not allowed. And now that they've been legalized, the registered partnerships are no more happening. So if you want to get married, you can either go to the church and you can either go to the registry and or go to the church. One thing you have to know is that you are free to go to the church, but then your marriage is not recognized legally. And sometimes the church would also tell you that, hey, what you're doing is just for you, but the law does not recognize this marriage, so you don't get the benefits that come with marriage, be it tax benefits or other benefits that come after divorce or after separation. This, you should know that. So if you want to get married legally, you should go to the registry with your partner, the local registry at either one of your residences. Normally you already choose one of you guys registries. You go to the registrar, you tell him you want to get married, and basically he will make sure that you guys are of eligible age. You guys, none of you is currently married to someone else, and that you've been in Germany long enough to get married. And that is definitely the criteria, and depending on the kind of couple that you are, the kind of countries that you come from, the criteria might change, or the qualifications might be more. You have to produce more documents, but this is the basic thing. So there are two, and you can also go to the church, as I've said. So there are two types. You can go to the church to get married, or you go to the registrar, but actually the registrar's marriage is the legal one. So legally speaking, there is one type of marriage.
The other question is, how is divorce done? Okay, unlike in German, where divorce is done more privately, you just involve lawyers and they communicate and all that. then divorce is done. In Zambia, you have to sue, regardless whether it's statutory or it's custom. The basic law is you need to sue. You need to allow the state know that you're divorcing. You need to go in court. You state your problems. This one speaks. In the end, they will divorce you if they feel like they deem fit that your marriage is broken and there's no way they could bring you together, then it will be rendered broken. But for a statutory one, even though they may divorce you, it's quite very difficult to find ground for divorce because they will try by all means to help you so that you can repair your marriage. They may tell you to go on separation and stuff like that. Yeah, so otherwise you both have to sue. It doesn't matter whether you got married at home. When it comes to separating, you have to sue through the court of law, competent court to divorce you guys. With the statutory, you have to sue from the high court, but with the other one, you just go to the local court, which is the traditional marriage.
So, what is the procedure for divorce? Before you get divorced, you'd be told that you have to be separated for at least 1 year. And after that 1 year, within that 1 year, you can actually try to reconcile and come back together. But if after that 1 year there is no reconciliation, then the marriage is then deemed broken, irreparable, or the marriage relationship is deemed as irreparable. And this 1 year only applies if both parties agree that they are going to get divorced. So let's say the man applies for divorce and the woman says no, then you'd have to wait for 3 years. And if those 3 years pass without any kind of reconciliation, then the marriage is also deemed as broken irreparably, and then you actually have an automatic divorce from that. So that is the process. And in Germany, nobody asks whose fault it is, unlike in the Ghanaian law where they would ask whose fault it was. So who cheated, who left who. In Germany, it's just Trennungsjahr, a year of separation, and after that, that's it. The next question is, how is divorce compensation determined? So divorce compensation is determined like this. Basically, the basic rule is that each man for himself after divorce, but if it should happen that one partner is financially way weaker and cannot sustain himself or herself after the divorce, then the one earning more will then be obliged to support the other person. The courts will then decide how much you have to pay to your partner. It's based on how much you earn. And it's also not forever, it's limited. So you're not going to be collecting money from your spouse after divorce forever. You are expected to also step up and take care of yourself as well. So that is basically it. So it depends on how much you earn, how much your partner earns, and all of that. Not everybody gets to get money from their partner. And also, one thing is that even before the divorce, you're also entitled to payment, but you have to apply for it just as with the compensation after divorce. The compensation, I think you mean alimony, right? Unterhalt. So with Unterhalt, there's Trennungsunterhalt, there's Unterhalt nach der Scheidung. Man muss die beide beantragen. Das ist nicht automatisch. It's not automatic. You have to apply for both in both cases and see your lawyer. See a family lawyer, not just go to any lawyer, just go to a family lawyer, that person who says Fachanwalt, Fachanwältin für, and see that person, talk to them, and they'll show you how things are going to go and what you have to produce, which document you have to bring to the table, or which documents that you have to give them for them to be able to work for you.
Okay, the other question is, how is compensation determined? That's quite tricky. In Zambia, normally the marriages, when they come to divorce, they determine compensation by, they look at the 40 of the parties. They'll look at who was at fault, who has really, really done a lot of big mess so that this marriage couldn't have worked. And normally the compensation will base on that. And mostly if you are responsible for that, you get less compensation. But in most cases, they would really love it that the lady get compensated, because mostly ladies are on the weak side. In most cases, sometimes they may never even be compensation. Yeah. But I like it the German way, because they don't try to find out who went wrong. If you just decide like your parting words, they look at it that way. They don't want to indulge themselves in how you lived and all stuff like that. But in Zambia, they want to dig deeper and know all these things. You tell them all your personal stuff and stuff like that. That's how composition, and every marriage is different. There's no standard like you get this and this. No, they look at different matters, and that's how your composition is going to come out. Yeah. The other question, Phoebe, we talked about was the sale, like the contract, how it's done. So when I talk about sale or contract, sale of contract, I basically refer to big things or big property like estate. That includes land, houses, and a little bit I can talk about a car. For a car, you can just sell yourself like privately. But in Zambia, you really need to like go to the court to swear in an affidavit for change of ownership. Then you can go to the RATSA and they'll change your name, put it on that car, then it's yours. But for house and land, you can sell privately and go to the court to swear that you have handed over this property to this person. Yeah. Or you can just go and do it from the judiciary, basically. But there are some people also that would want to involve a lawyer, which is good. Yes. Though, I don't know, when it comes to a big property like houses, I would recommend that you involve a lawyer or you go to the judiciary. But if you feel like you're comfortable, you can even do it privately. But it's always good to have backup because anything can happen.
The next question, or the last question, is the sale of estate. How does that go? So if you're buying a home, if you're buying a piece of land, a plot of land, basically it is not just a regular sales contract. It's estates, right? So if you're buying any house or any kind of estate, you go to the notary. So after you have found your buyer, I mean your seller or your buyer, either way, both of you go to the notary, who then investigates whether the piece of property, or whether that property is really registered under that person's name, and whether it is actually possible to sell or to transfer the ownership, and that the notary is going to be the person in charge of transferring the ownership. He's going to take care of all of that, and also make sure that the contract, the sale contract between you two, is also done. So you're definitely going to need a notary, and without him, that sale is not valid. So make sure that you go to a notary if you're going to buy a house. Make sure he asks for a notar must sign, determined by notar. It's una leslish. So go to the notary and have them investigate, have them see if it's possible for you to transfer ownership and whether you can even buy the house at all. The notary also conclude the contract. So you basically actually conclude the contract in the notary's office. So that's it, guys. I hope this has given you an insight. If you're trying to get married, if you're trying to get divorced, don't beat yourself. Not everything is supposed to last. And sometimes you need that break. You need that freedom. So don't beat yourself up. Not everything is supposed to last, as I said. Sometimes your divorce is your breakthrough. So don't feel bad about that. They're not going to ask whether you cheated or not. Definitely not. So don't worry about that. Just make sure that you're separated for at least a year. And yes, if your partner says no, separate even longer, for 3 years. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any further questions, shoot me an email, comment down below. Check out Patricia's channel. Take good care of yourselves. Bleibt zuversichtlich, bleibt gesund, nehmt Abstand. Put on your masks. And guys, stay hopeful, stay healthy, and see you same time next week. Ciao.